So how do we improve reliability and availability? We can try to avoid faults, which is about preventing faults from occurring in the first place. For example, the no coffee in the server room is one example of a fault avoidance technique. If we spill the coffee on a server, that's probably gonna be a fault. So we're trying to avoid that fault by preventing people from bringing coffee into the server room. Next, we can have a fault tolerance technique. They're about preventing faults from graduating into failures. A typical fault tolerance technique will use redundancy. For example, ECC can be used for memory, and ECC stands for error correcting code. So what happens is, if there is a fault, for example, a particle strike that flips a bit in memory, ECC will allow us to read that block from memory, realize that one of the bits has been flipped, and actually correct that bit. And then we can also have techniques like speeding up the repair, which really affect only availability. And an example of such a technique is when we have a spare hard drive in a drawer, so when a hard drive fails, we can quickly replace it. So this is a technique where basically the failure will still occur, but we will shorten the period that it takes to repair the system by basically, in this case, not having to wait for a new hard drive to arrive. We already have one handy on site. So we will now look more closely at the fault tolerance techniques, which are usually techniques that we can apply in computer architecture to try to prevent faults from becoming failures, and thus make systems both more reliable and more available.